Moving on for now to Sudan, which is caught in the midst of an escalating political crisis. In the latest, 7 people have lost their lives, more than 140 have been injured. People have been taking to the streets, marking their protests. The world leaders are condemning the military coup, and the military chief of Sudan is blaming the politicians. In a first public appearance after the dramatic coup, the army chief has accused the politicians of driving Sudan towards a civil war.
ذلك من يتحدث عن العنصرية كلها كانت ترمي إلى اقتياد البلد إلى حرب أهلية ترمي إلى تفتيت البلد ترمي إلى الطعن في وحدته في تماسكه في نسيجه الاجتماعي هذه مخاطر أصبحت ماثلة أمامنا ورأيناها تزاع على الملأ وتحدث عنها الجميع بصوت بدون مواربة يتحدث عنها الجميع بدون حتى الإحساس بأن هذه المسائل لديها تأثير مباشر على الأمن الوطني هذه المسائل التي يحدثون عنها لديها تأثير مباشر على وحدة القوات النظامية
General Abdel Fattah al-Burhan now heads a military council that would rule Sudan until elections in July 2023. As per the army chief, the military stepped in after protests refused to die down, after talks between the Prime Minister Abdullah Hamdok and the protest movement reached a deadlock. In short, the army chief wants to convey that the military acted responsibly for the betterment of the Sudanese people. But the streets are depicting a completely different story. Protesters have remained defiant. Even on Tuesday, they have been taking to the streets for the second day in a row, protesting against the military coup. The capital city of Khartoum is witnessing mass protests. On Monday, soldiers had opened fire on the demonstrators, reportedly killing 7 people.
ضربوا رصاص في 2 وقع ديل ماتوا انا شفتهم بعيني وفي بتاع تاتشر وطلعوا واحد عديل ورجعوا فيهم مرتين يا زول لثالث واحد ماشي
Videos have emerged on social media of the chaos that unfolded following the coup. People can be seen running from the gunfire in the capital city. Young people who have been marking their protests have been clashing with the troops. Sudan is no stranger to a coup. In fact, the last attempt was foiled just last month and forged a divide between the military and the civilian leaders, who have always been uneasy coalition partners. In 2019, Sudan's long-term authoritarian president Omar al-Bashir was overthrown. Though Bashir was removed by the military, mass street demonstrations demanding civilian rule forced the military to negotiate a plan aimed at moving towards a democratic government. The country was being run by the military and civilian leaders together on a joint committee known as the Foreign Council. This coup has once again set back Sudan's fragile transition to democracy.